best things to do in Prague are so amazing. However, places are not always easy to locate, even when it may be your first time. In this video, I will show you what it is like to travel to Prague in the Czech Republic today. So sit back and chill, and let's go. Arriving to Prague was great. After a 10-hour flight, I needed to check into my room. So I had two separate Airbnb rentals while I was visiting, and this one ended up being my favorite. I had a good living room space to relax and enough space for my laundry, shower, etc. And I love the small kitchen, definitely a space for tourists. Nevertheless, I made it safe. After a long flight, I needed a quick boost of energy. Juicing has many micronutrients to keep the body up and moving. And I did not want to waste time. I mean, I am visiting Prague. The statue of Kafka is an outdoor sculpture by David Czerny, depicting Bohemian German language writer Franz Kafka installed outside the Quadrio shopping center in Prague. The kinetic sculpture is about 11 meters tall and made of 42 rotating panels. This design inspires many architects. A must place visit. Church of Our Lady has two Gothic towers. It has been the main church of a part of the city since the 14th century. The two church towers are roughly 80 meters high and is visible throughout the city, although the view from the ground is fascinating as well. One of Prague's most popular landmarks is the Astronomical Clock, located in Old Town Square. It is well over 600 years old and is one of the oldest functional astronomical clocks in the world. The Astronomical Clock in Prague shows the relative position of the Sun, Moon, Earth, and zodiac constellations. It also tells the time, provides a date, and best of all, provides some theater for its viewers on the hour, every hour. With all the walking and sightseeing, I got thirsty and needed a break. I paid a visit to Molostransky Café beer restaurant, because Prague recommends this place. However, I did not want a beer just yet, nor wanted a full belly, but wanted to ensure I sat down for their refreshments. So I took one last photo and I was on my way. I will leave the link in the description below. With the jet lag and excitement, I slept like a rock. Waking up with another day of excitement, I needed a good breakfast for a full day. Oh, by the way, I brought this little guy with me to Prague, a travel souvenir. Right next door to my stay was a nice sit-down breakfast cafe, the Mondieu Organic Bistro and Chocolate. I will admit, I came here daily and the service and food was excellent. I had my usual favorite, California avocado toast. They must have found out that I was from California because it was made with perfection. Thank you, chef. I will leave the link in the description below. First thing I needed to do was get familiar with the transit. I love European transits. They are common in Europe and most locals, or all, use it. So let's go for a ride. Thank you. later, or in Czech, Narodní divadlo in Prague is known as the Alma Mater of Czech opera and as a national monument of Czech history and art. The cornerstone of the National Theater was laid on 1868, but the idea dates back to 1844 at the gathering of the Patriots in Prague. A good place to take your photo, or if you're lucky, get an event ticket to go inside and watch a theater. Day was looking great, sun was out and the skies were clearing up, so I decided to pull out my DJI drone for a little fun and some aerial shots in Park Lehigh, a beautiful and relaxing park on the little island on the river. Great views of the Carl's Bridge and Riverside. You can grab a drink from one of the small food stalls. Perfect place for a hangout on a warm afternoon. Very nice atmosphere and clean too. Another great place to visit is Café Savoy. It is one of the most famous places to visit and eat in Prague. I recommend booking a reservation as this place tends to get very busy during the day. I had the Egg Benedict with my favorite espresso and enjoyed my meal very much. Also, was tempted to try their fresh desserts after. I made two reservations during my stay in Prague. A must place to visit. I was ready for some real food and the body was craving some serious protein. So I walked into restaurant Café Batejo Vaclava, located in the center of Prague, the upper part of Venceslas Square. The restaurant is named after Saint Venceslas in 907 through 935, a Czech prince who is considered the main patron of Czech land. The atmosphere was real and the food was fantastic. I went with the duck and I will be going back. Month of February, Valentine's Day roses were everywhere. I could not resist, so I decided to buy a rose and send a photo to a dear friend at home. Rohlíku is one of the best Czech fast food grab and go hot dog stands that has survived for a very long time, according to locals. Many tourists come to simply try, so here you go. A huge selection of sauces to choose from, 6 different kinds of mustards, 3 kinds of ketchup, and even tartar sauce. The hot dog itself was nicely smoked and perfectly spiced. The bun was a little crispy on the outside and soft inside. In 1342, Prague built a medieval bridge of sandstone blocks as the only means of crossing the Vltava River. In 1841, it was renamed as the Charles Bridge connecting the Prague Castle and Old Town. The view on this bridge is breathtaking. If you want to take a great photo, I recommend coming to the bridge 15 to 20 minutes before the sun rises. It will be priceless. It is the next day, and most of my friends and family know I love the gym, so I found a great place called The Form Factory, where I was able to do some stretching and a little bit of strength training. I was also grateful to meet some new friends in class, and the instructor was superb. So much fun, and everyone was nice. Now that I am full of energy, I am ready to explore. Prague Castle has been an important symbol of the Czech state for more than 1,000 years. According to the Genesis Book of Records, Prague Castle is the largest coherent castle complex in the world. Prague is one of those places that seems like it was plucked straight from a fairy tale. A must place to visit. The dancing house, built in 1992, a very non-traditional design, was erected and was controversial in Prague because the house stands out amongst the Baroque Gothic architecture in the area. Today, many locals find it accepting as many tourists visit the site. Nowadays, the building serves as a newly opened luxury hotel, which offers 40 luxurious rooms with unforgettable views of Prague Castle, a cafe, and a top floor restaurant. At the top of the house, you will find amazing panoramic terrace where you can admire the city and a sky view. Interesting enough, there is a gold coin of the dancing house. They call it the 10th century of architecture and is about the size of a US quarter. Dancing House is named one of the five most important buildings in the 1990s by Architect Magazine. The National Museum, or the Národní Museum, is a Czech museum institution intended to systematically establish, prepare, and publicly exhibit natural scientific and historic collections. It was founded in 1818 by Caspar Maria Sternberg. The National Museum houses nearly 14 million items from the areas of natural history, history arts, music, and librarianship. The statue of Saint Venceslas in Prague, Czech Republic, depicts Venceslas I, Duke of Bohemia, installed at Venceslas Square, a city emblem and popular gathering place. This is where people hang out. My personal opinion is, once you've taken a picture in front of this historic foundation and statues, Prague is now forever with you. The following morning, everything seemed to fall into place. I was getting familiar with the streets in Prague. Cukrárna St. Tropez, just around the corner from the Charles Bridge, is a hidden little cafe shop that has a wide selection of treats. I mean, I felt like I was inside the Willy Wonka chocolate factory. A child who could not select just one because there were such a variety of different chocolates. Services was great, staff were very polite, and their treats are handmade. This place is a must visit. Circling back to this area, cafe restaurant Střelecky Ostrov, a one-of-a-kind type of lunch I very much enjoyed viewing the Vltava River. Sizable eatery with vaulted snugs, a large windowed gallery, and a bar with a European menu. I went with the chicken and potatoes. The day was beautiful, and the view was something I can always remember. There are two towers on the Charles Bridge. The smaller tower was built in the 12th century, and the taller Gothic tower was built in the second half of the 15th century. The Gothic tower at the lesser town side of the Charles Bridge was part of the left bank fortification, and in the early 15th century, it served as a prison for the worst criminals then. You can enter today for a fee. This allows you to climb up to the ledge above the gate and then up some stairs where you will see a few exhibits as you go up to the top of the tower. The view was amazing. A great place to visit. Another place to visit is the Lokál Czech restaurant. I got there by transit and walked a few feet and I was there. The restaurant is said to be one of those that offer traditional Czech cuisines. Out of old Czech traditions and that purity of it, it is everything they do. You will find the taste in the beer, find the taste in their foods, and everything else. To add, a pub where they cook everything fresh, like it's from a home kitchen grandma made for you, without substitutions, without anything shortened, just like they cook at home. I went with the chicken and rice, and I am very happy they gave me two servings of the rice because I could not get enough of their amazing gravy. A must place visit. Another morning and I was loving my stay in Prague. So I made some morning coffee and checked my gym laundry and headed to the gym for a morning strength workout. Hit the transit to find a place called Bread Gap. The Bread Gap is only walking distance from the Charles Bridge. The first thing I noticed was their sign. It displayed, "Prepared by people, not robots." Which is true, because my coffee was made by who I believe was the owner himself. A private little bakery which locals support. I went with a medium cafe latte and a breakfast croissant. The owner was kind and friendly. We chatted for a while, and I was on my way. As I was exploring, I came across this chocolate shop by chance, Pralinky Újezd, or pralines. As soon as I entered, I was greeted by the pleasant of chocolate aroma. I definitely recommend the pralines. They are delicious and the services were excellent. I had the most decorative chocolates I have ever seen by design. A chocolate paradise for all. I walked away with the gift box full of pralines. I highly recommend this place. The Church of St. Nicholas, or in Czech, Kostel Svatého Mikuláši, is a Baroque church in the lesser town of Prague. It was built between 1704 through 1755 on the site where formerly Gothic church from the 13th century stood, which was also dedicated to St. Nicholas. It has been described as the greatest example of Prague. The bell tower is right next to it. In 1755, it also served as a fire watchtower in Prague. If you want to get to the top, it will take you 215 steps. I was lucky to have my first Airbnb stay with a window view looking at this magnificent church. You have to check it out. Another great place is Martha's Kitchen, just on the other side of the Vltava River. A new friend I met in Prague highly recommended this place, so we went. Every morning at 3 a.m., they start with their fresh baked breads, also gluten-free for the record. It is traditional handmade baking methods they use inside their kitchen, from breakfast to lunch and even dinner. This place makes you enjoy great taste of what Prague can offer. Place was hands down the best. I went with the avocado breaded with poached egg. Great atmosphere, polite staff members, and the food was superb. A must place visit. Prague is big and gorgeous. If I can make one small recommendation, is to contact Francesco, who can guide you and even take your photos. You can find him through the Airbnb experience. Well, you made it to the end. I am new to YouTube, and I hope this guide helped you make some future plans. If you liked this video and found it engaging, please like and subscribe. It would help the channel so much. You guys are awesome. My name is Tony. Until the next one, stay healthy and active. Goodbye.